Myself, Rushali R. Thakkar from M.H. Sabu Siddiq College of Engineering, Assistant Professor in Electronics Department. The topic today I will be discussing will be on embedded system. A brief summary about the last 2 week videos. In week one, it was basically the description of the embedded system and what are the different applications and how does it affect on the environment and sustainability. So there are various design challenges which include accurate thermal modeling and derating components differently for each design depending on operating environment. In week 2, we had seen the different standards, ISO standards, IEC standards which are related to the embedded system and which affect the functionality, the safety of our complex and interconnected technologies and the systems. Today's video outcomes will be emissions which are associated with the electrical vehicles, comparison of carbon emission electric vehicles, and sensitive analysis. So there are various electrical vehicles, battery electric vehicle, plug-in hybrid electric vehicle, and conventional vehicle. So now in battery electrical vehicle, we can see that it is using 100% electrical operation. Plug-in, it can operate on both electricity and internal combustion. And in CVs, you are having 100% internal combustion. So now, all the three electrical vehicles are having some or the other different emissions which are associated with electrical vehicle charging. Now, in this slide, we will see how are you going to calculate the emissions from this BEV. If BEV range is sufficient for the trip, the owner chooses the BEV. If BEV range is insufficient for the trip, the owner chooses the CV. Emissions from BEV charging are a function of the local grid's generation profile and BEV's efficiency. While driving the CV, we assume a fuel efficiency of 40.8 mpg, which translates to emissions of approximately 0.48. So total emissions from BEV travel are sum of the emissions from BEV and the CV. Here you can find the comparison of life cycle greenhouse gas emission in conventional, electric and plug-in hybrid vehicles. The studies indicate that battery production is associated with 56 to 494 kilograms of carbon dioxide per kilowatt hour of battery capacity for electric vehicles. Several of these studies also provide estimates for the equivalent amount of emissions per kilometer driven over the vehicle lifetimes. These generally find 1 to 2 g CO2 per kilometer per kWh of the battery capacity. Going ahead, we have to find out the sustainability or the sensitivity of BEV emissions, which are related to higher and lower carbon intensities. Home and workplace charging scenarios are shown below in the diagram. This table shows the adjustments which are made to the original electricity grid profiles for the sensitivity analysis. So high renewable sensitivity adjustment and low renewable sensitivity adjustment for different grid scenarios, which is consisting of low carbon, medium low carbon, medium high carbon and high carbon. So low renewable sensitivity adjustment is not applicable for high carbon grid scenario. Thank you.